wouldn't go anywhere but 191 South.
I didn't know which game to watch, so I went to 191 and watched them all.
We had my sister's bridal shower there, and it was perfect.
Don't be a stranger. Stop in to 191 South. Whether it's time to tie the knot, celebrate a birthday, or toast a 50th anniversary, 191 South can accommodate your party, whether it's 15 or 500 people. Be sure to join us for lunch or dinner, or pay us a visit on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday for the hottest bands in Chicago performing live on stage. 191 South, home of rhythm and food.
If you're a landlord or property manager looking to screen your prospective tenants, call Advanced Credit Reports at 708-748-9200. Our services include credit reports, verification of residency and employment, and criminal background checks. There is no annual fee, no membership fee, no sign-up fee, and no hidden fees. Receive your prospective tenant's credit report within an hour. For more information, you can visit us online at www.advancedcreditreports.com.
With all the miles you're driving, are you keeping up with your regular maintenance? We can fix that. Trust the experts to take care of all your maintenance needs. Call 773-238-0606. Brock's Auto Center, your trustworthy service center for the last 25 years. Mention this ad and receive a lube oil and filter change for $21.95. At Brock's, we can fix that.
If you'd like to play in a future televised Windy City Poker Championship, here's a schedule of our future productions. But if TV isn't your thing, you should check out the non-televised tournaments being offered by Main Event Charity Games. So log on today and sign up at maineventcharitygames.com. Seats fill up very fast. For more information, you can email us. Our email address is info@windycitypokerchampionship.com.
This portion of the show is brought to you by Aztec Audio, Video, and Communications. Aztec has specialized in design and installation of both commercial and residential audio video systems since 2001. Set up an appointment today to have one of their technicians help you set up and manage your in-house audio visual needs. They provide free consultations to help you find what you're looking for. For more information, call Aztec Audio, Video, and Communications at 773-502-8383. Be sure to check them out online at aztechav.com. That's aztechav.com. Welcome back to Windy City Poker Championship. We're three-handed at Chief O'Neill's. Blinds are at 15 and 30,000 with a 5,000 chip ante. Chris is first to act.
Calling.
Brent Snap calls with the ace of hearts, four of hearts, suited ace. This is just what you were talking about, Kirk. The small stacks are picking on one another. Jerry can just pitch his cards away and let them do their damage.
Dominated. Jerry folds. Brent's all in for his tournament life up against Chris. Right now he's a 3-2 favorite to take down this hand.
I lose these a lot, so.
He's got more chips.
Here we go to the flop. The flop is 5-ace-10 with two diamonds.
Wow.
Both players connect with that flop.
Wow. Yeah. They did, Kirk, but Brent improves his lead. He's now a 4-1 favorite over Chris.
No diamonds. No one's got diamonds.
Four.
Wow, that does some serious damage to Chris's chip stack. He's got less than three big blinds.
Thanks, man. Yeah, it's going to be real close.
Kirk, we start this hand off with 60,000 in chips in the pot, and Chris only has 42,000 left in his stack. Both of the other players left at this table are conscious of the fact he's going to call them with just about any two cards. In this spot, I'm looking for a king, an ace, or any pocket pair, and that's about it.
No way. Wow. Wow. It was that bad? Wow.
Any card that he had would be.
Jason, just like you said, it's any two cards at this point for Chris.
That's right, Kirk. He picked up just enough chips on that last hand to put his opponents to a decision.
Wow. count, please.
Now, Jason, Brent's getting about 2-1 to make this call right here. Last time he was in this situation, he folded. However, Chris is starting to pick up some momentum, so he just might call here with six high.
That's right, Kirk. And he knows Chris could have any two cards. On the other hand, he's only got six high. If he puts his chips in the pot, he's going to be wary. Is he dominated?
I call.
And Brent makes the call. Chris is all in for his tournament life, but ahead right now, Jason.
You got me crushed, dude.
5-6, a good hand.
I think we're like 60-40. Yeah.
You're ahead. 5-6, it's coming.
Well, that's a pretty good flop for Chris. He still leads with his 10 high.
Turn card comes a jack of hearts.
Oh, that's an interesting card, Kirk. This gives Brent some chop outs. Any of the remaining threes, they'll split the pot.
Oh! And the river's a five of hearts.
Cruel, cruel world.
Chris gets knocked out in third place. Michael is standing by outside to talk to our former chip leader. Michael?
This is it.
This was the final table you've been playing all day. What happened out there?
Probably just got maybe a little too aggressive at the end. I made a questionable call at ace-2, I guess. The guy who shoved in was pretty aggressive, so thought I might be ahead.
I mean, at one time, you had the most chips out there, and you were going to be the crown leader of this. What was your strategy going into this game?
Definitely just to be aggressive, which I think I followed pretty well. It just didn't work out. I really enjoyed the event. Just well run, lots of good dealers and good floor people, and yeah, it was a well run tournament.
Well, Kirk, as we go into heads up action, the players are neck and neck. One big blind separates the two of them. We've got an aggressive player, we've got a calculated player.
My specialty is heads up, so just like you should know.
What's that?
Just like you should know.
That? I didn't hear you.
I'm sorry. I play heads up all the time.
Oh, do you? All right. I don't.
You don't?
Thank you. It's my first time.
No, it's not.
Both players check the flop. Jerry's going to lead out for 50,000 here on the river. He knows he can't win a showdown with six high. Brent thinks about it, and he folds his nine high, and Jerry takes down the first pot and heads up action.
I'm going to get serious now.
You're supposed to. I thought you always been serious.
I don't know if I'm a serious player or not.
This is my first time playing heads up.
No, it's not.
Really? As a dealer. First time I made the final table, seriously. Okay.